हेलो माय डियर किड्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एंड हेल्दी एट योर होम्स। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, एज योर यूनिट टेस्ट आर ओवर, नाउ वी विल कंटिन्यू विद आवर वर्चुअल क्लासेस, दैट इज ई क्लासेस। सो वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ सेंट जोसेफ्स अकेडमी for class 5th, subject social studies, lesson 6, part 3, the Indian constitution, prepared by Durga Thapa. Students, so let's begin part 3 of lesson number 6, the Indian constitution. Students, in this lesson, the Indian Constitution, we have studied about the meaning of Indian Constitution, the need for Indian Constitution, salient features of Indian Constitution, and the last point was the importance of Indian Constitution. Students, let's revise the Constitution. So, what is a constitution? Or in other words, we can say, what is the meaning of a constitution? So, a constitution is a fundamental legal document that contains the rule according to which the government of a country functions. Yes, and these rules or laws are called the basic laws, which we all Indians have to follow. Students, this is the picture of the Constitution of India. Yes, it is a book, because Indian Constitution is a written document, so it is also known as the living document. Yes, a constitution is a living document, and all the laws and rights, duties, all are written in this book, that is the Indian Constitution. It means that it is constantly grows and evolves according to the needs of the people of the country. Yes. Students, we have also studied about the salient features of the Indian Constitution. Yes, number one is the preamble. Number two, a detailed written constitution. Yes, a sovereign democratic republic. Number four is a socialist and secular state. Number five, the single citizenship. Number six, the independent judiciary. Number seven, parliamentary system. Number eight, fundamental rights. Number nine, fundamental duties. And number ten is directive principles. Yes, we have studied these all ten salient features in the detail. So students, the lesson is over. Now we will proceed our exercises. Question number A, choose the correct answer. Yes, here for each question, three options are given as answers and we have to select the correct answer. Number one is, a constitution is a fundamental dash. So there are three options: legal document, social document, and economic document. So what will be the correct answer? A constitution is a fundamental legal document. Yes, the answer is, a constitution is a fundamental legal document. Number two, our constitution is a unique example of option A, flexibility, option B, continuous growth, and option C, both A and B. So what will the correct answer? Our constitution is a unique example of both flexibility and continuous growth. Yes, our constitution is a unique example of flexibility and continuous growth. Number three is, originally our constitution had option A 400 articles, option B 395 articles, and option C 300 articles. And I think all the students are able to give the answer. Yes, the correct answer is 395 articles. Originally, our constitution had 395 articles. Fourth, our constitution has guaranteed option A, 7 fundamental rights, option B, 8 fundamental rights, option C, 6 fundamental rights. Now students, can you remember what we have studied in this lesson? Yes, very good. We have studied that our constitution had guaranteed 6 fundamental rights. They are right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights, and the last one is right to constitutional remedies. Yes, so what will be the answer? Very good. The answer will be yes. Our constitution has guaranteed 6 fundamental rights. The fifth point is, there are number of fundamental duties. Option A 10, option B 11, and option C 12. So hurry up, try to remember the answer. We have studied in the lesson. Yes, what will be the correct answer? 10, 11, or 12? Yes, very good. The answer is, there are 11 fundamental duties. Yes, very good. There are number of fundamental duties is 11. Dear students, let's proceed to the next question, that is, answer the following questions. Question number B is, answer the following questions. Yes, now we have to give the answers to the questions. The first question is, what is a constitution? Explain. And in this lesson, we have studied that a constitution is a fundamental legal document that contains the rules according to which the government of a country functions. Yes. Question number two is, why is constitution needed a democratic country? So that means here we have to write down the need of a constitution in a democratic country. The answer is, constitution is needed for the following reasons. The first reason is for the participation of citizen in functioning of the government. Yes, it is very compulsory. For the participation of the citizen is compulsory in the functioning of the government. Yes, number two is to fulfill the needs of people, and number three is to fulfill social, political, and economic aspirations. Students, here comes the question number three. Mention any 5 salient features of the Indian Constitution. Students, we have studied 10 salient features of the Indian Constitution in this lesson. So we have to write down here any 5 salient features. So we will begin with the first salient feature, that is the preamble. Number 2, a detailed written constitution. As we know that our constitution, Indian Constitution, is a written constitution. Number 3, single citizenship. Number 4, fundamental rights. And number 5 is fundamental duties. So these are the 5 salient features that we have written. Okay. Next question is, write in brief about the fundamental duties. Yes, the answer is, the Constitution of India lays down 11 fundamental duties which the citizen of India should perform seriously and sincerely. So, these are the 11 fundamental duties which we all Indian has to follow, perform seriously and sincerely. Okay? The last question is, what is the importance of constitution in a democratic country? Yes, so can you tell me? We have studied this in our lesson. What is the importance of constitution in a democratic country? Yes, the answer is, the constitution of our country defines the powers and responsibilities of each organ of the government. Yes, it also states our rights and duties as citizens, what we have to do, what are our rights, and it contains our national goals such as democracy, secularism and socialism. So it is very important in our country, that is a democratic country, because it is good for the citizens and is also good at a part of government. Okay. Our next question is, write true or false. So here 5 sentences are given. Some are right and some are wrong. So for the right sentence, we have to write down true, and for the false sentence, we have to write down false. Okay, so let's start. Sentence number 1. A good constitution constantly grows according to the needs and aspirations of the people. So, yes, this is true. Our constitution is a written constitution, and so according to the needs, it grows accordingly. Okay, so this sentence is true. Number two sentence is, our constitution is a non-living organism. It is false. Yes, the sentence is false because it is a written document and it is a living organism which grows according to need. Yes. Number 3, the preamble declares that India is a socialist and a secular country. So this is true or false? Tell me fast. Yes, this is true sentence. Yes, because at the first page of our constitution, that is Indian constitution, shows the preamble and it declares that India is a socialist and a democratic secular country. So this sentence is true. Very good. Number 4 sentence, the Indian constitution is the lengthiest constitution of the world. So students, please tell me fast, this is true or false? Yes, very good. This is true. The Indian constitution is the lengthiest written constitution of the world. The sentence is true. Okay. The last sentence is, the fundamental duties have been added by the 30th amendment of the Indian constitution. So this is true or false? Tell me fast. Yes, this is false. Why this is false? Because the the fundamental duties have been added by the 42 amendment of the Indian Constitution, not in the 30th amendments. So this sentence is false. Okay. So the first one is true, second is false, third is true, fourth is again true, and the fifth one is false. Okay. Here students, our last question is, fill in the blanks. So here 5 sentences are given with some blanks and we have to fill in the correct answer. So the first sentence is, our constitution starts with the dash. So can you tell me the answer? we have studied in this lesson? Yes, very good. The answer is preamble. Preamble? Yes. Our constitution starts with the preamble. Number two, India is a dash country. So the answer is yes, India is a secular country. Number three, there are dash fundamental duties in our constitution. So very good. Hurry up, tell me how many fundamental duties are there in Indian constitution? Yes, very good. There are 11 fundamental duties in our constitution. Number sentence number 4. The purpose of the directive principles is to fix certain dash and dash reforms in the country. Yes, the answer is the purpose of the directive principles is to fix certain social and economic reforms in the country. The answer is social and economic reforms in the country. Very good. Now next is the last sentence is right to freedom is a dash right. So which type of right is this? Yes, very good. This is fundamental right. So right to freedom is a fundamental right. So answer number 1, preamble. Answer 2, secular. Answer 3, 11 fundamental duties. Answer 4, social and economic reforms. And number 5 is fundamental right. Okay, students. Now, students, here is the time for some home assignment. So, your home assignment is number 1, do question answers in your copy in very good cursive handwriting. And number 2 is you have to complete question A, that is choose the correct answer. Question C, that is fill in the blanks. And question D, that is true false in your book. So question answers has to be done in copy and all the other questions has to be completed in books in very good handwriting. Okay. Thank you, my dear students, for watching the video patiently. Have a nice day.